So today's topic is we'll starting from different kinds of field which can be have for an antenna. So what are the different kinds of fields we can find when the antenna is radiating in the far distant point? So we can able to segregate these field regions. Okay, so field regions. The different field regions. So let us consider we are having a simple dipole antenna. So when it will radiate, what are the different field regions can we have depending upon the distance from the antenna? So if we consider this is the center point, this is the center point. So if we take a radius, so at which radius what are the different fields can exist? So we can able to segregate this field regions depending upon the distance from the antenna center. Let us consider. So if we draw a simple circle around this antenna, so let us consider it is having the radius R1. If we go other than far distance from this, so we can have different other regions also, R2. Outside this we can have still different other regions. So depending upon this R1, R2, R3 or some other distance point, we can have first region known as radiative near field. Radiative near field, that is your R1. So this radiative near field, it is the field which immediately surrounds the antenna. The field which immediately surrounds the antenna. So this distance R1 is less than, if we consider this is the length of the antenna, let us consider it is D. So this R1 is less than 0.62 root over D cube by lambda. Lambda is the operating wavelength. Then we are having radiating near field. So it is reactive near field, means it is having certain reactive characteristics in nature. Reactive means it can have the characteristics of power been deposited or power been absorbed, rather it has been radiated from the antenna. So within this region the power is not at all been able to have the radiation characteristics. It can have the characteristics like it is absorbed by the antenna element. So how we'll see. Next we'll have radiating near field. This is given by this R2. R2 is equals to been considered as 2d square by lambda. Okay, next, outside of this R2 we are having far field region. This is also known as Fresnel's region. Outside or R2, the distance greater than this R2, we are having the far field, which is the main radiating field being considered for any antenna, because our intention is to have the signal at a far distance. Far field region, or it is also known as Fraunhofer region. When the distance is greater than R2, we are having this far field region, that is Fraunhofer region. So our main consideration will be with respect to this Fraunhofer region. Now let us solve a simple problem depending upon this HPBW or FNBW. So HPBW indicates the half power level. So when we have been considering half power, what does it mean? We are considering the normalized power level, which is half. So if we go with this power level, that is dB value, so it will always been taken as 0.707, that is 1/√2. So if we go with this normalized power field pattern, if you are representing this field pattern by electric field, that is in elevation plane, so normalized value is E theta theta phi normalized is equals to E theta theta phi by normalized value been considered with respect to the maximum value max. Okay, so field pattern, if you have been writing with respect to electric field and if you are dealing with this normalized value, then we need to find out like this. So whenever we have been finding either half power or first null beam width, we have been going with this normalized value. So this HPBW occurs at those angles of theta comma phi for which E theta theta comma phi normalized is 1/√2, that is 0.707, so half power level. So power is represented in terms of dB. So whenever we have been considering half power, that is it's supposed to be 0.707 value or level of that power. So if we consider, or somewhere if it has been given that we need to find out half power level, then always we have been considering that power should be equated with 1/√2 or 0.707. so if we do a simple problem on this, an antenna has a field pattern given by E theta is equals to cos square theta. Just try to understand what is the expression been given. E theta is given for theta, for 0 less than is equals to theta less than is equals to 90 degree. So theta is ranging from 0 to 90. Find HPBW. Okay, so the solution will be like this: E theta at half power is equals to 0.707. So we'll equate this E theta with 0.707 or 1/√2. So therefore 0.707 is equals to cos square theta. So from here we need to find out the value of theta. Theta is coming out as 33 degree. So always whenever we are been having this theta value, so finding out HPBW, we need to take twice of theta. So therefore HPBW is twice of theta, that is 66 degree. So if we are having this kind of radiation pattern, something like this, so HPBW means something like this. So this is our total, this should be similar. So this one is your one theta, this is your another theta. So for this kind of pattern, we can have the HPBW is equals to 66 degree. Next problem: an antenna has a field pattern given by E theta is equals to cos theta cos of twice theta. For 0 less than theta less than 90 degree. Find first point HPBW, second point FNBW. So same as like this, HPBW means fill pattern will be compared with point or equated with 0.707 or 1 by root 2, and FNBW will be considered for 0 power level. So this fill pattern should be equated with 0. So this E theta, which is cos theta cos of twice theta, is equals to 0.707 or 1 by root 2. So equate this and find out this theta value. So when you are having this theta value, you will have the HPBW for twice of theta. So I am just writing the final value for this theta. Theta is coming out as 20.5 degree and HPBW is your twice theta, which is 41 degree. Next, FNBW, E theta, which is cos theta cos of twice theta, will be 0. So your theta is coming out as 45 degree. Therefore, FNBW, it is twice of theta, which is 90 degree. So this mathematical calculations you can do. Just try to understand the concept how we are having this HPBW or FNBW. So whenever any fill pattern, it is, just try to understand, it is pattern. It is fill pattern. So whenever it has been given, we need to consider 1 by root 2 level. Okay. So if the power pattern is given, so power pattern means it is already E square. So power pattern means E square. Let us consider this E square means V square. So V square by R is the power. So R let us consider as 1. So if power is given, then you need to consider E square. So E square means it should become half. Now we'll have the direct value of half power level. But as it is given for the field pattern, either for the electric field or for the magnetic field, we need to consider 1 by root 2. So for the time being, just try to understand this much. We'll do some more problem on this. Next, we'll go with beam area. So before understanding this beam area, we need to understand what is radian. So radian is the angle subtended by an arc for a circle, right? So what is the length of that arc? It is the length of the arc is the same radius of that circle. So if we are having a circle, we are having a circle like this with this center, we can have this radius r, we can have anywhere this radius r. So if you take the same arc length of radius r, then what is the length is extended by that radius? That subtended length, that is radius, is making an angle at the center of the circle. That angle is known as 1 radian, right? So the angle with its vertex at the center of the circle of radius r, that is subtended by an arc whose length is r, same as this r. Okay, so the angle with its vertex at the center of a circle of radius r, that is subtended by the arc whose length is same as r. So what is the total radian for a circle? If the circumference is 2 pi r, the total radian is 2 pi radian. So total radian included in a circle is 2 pi radian. Now if instead of this circle we are having a sphere, then that angle is known as steradian. So let us consider we are having a circle, a sphere. So inside, if this is the center, inside we are taking an 3D area whose area is same as the area of a square with each side is equals to r, that is radius of this sphere, then that area is making an angle at the center of the sphere, that is known as one steradian. So this radius is r. Okay, so that measure of this steradian, it is also known as solid angle. So what is this steradian? One steradian is defined as the solid angle with its vertex at the center of the sphere of radius r, that is subtended by a spherical surface area, equal to that of a square with each side of length r. So just try to understand, you are having a sphere of radius r, you should need to take that much of area, it is equals to, it should be equals to the area of a square whose each side is r. So if you have been having a square of each side is equals to the same radius of that sphere, that r square, obviously the area of this square will be r square, you need to take the same area on that sphere which is equals to same as r square, and that area is having an angle at the center of that sphere, that angle is known as one steradian or one solid angle. Understand? This area, how much if for this radian you have been taken an arc length is equals to the same radius of that circle, you have been taking the arc length of r. But for this case you need to consider an area which is equals to the area of a square which is having the same side is equals to the radius of that sphere. So if we have been taking that much area, that area is making how much angle at the center, that will be considered as in one steradian. So what is the difference? Difference is that the circle is an 2D object, this sphere is an 3D object. So obviously whenever we need to consider the radiation, we need to consider the 3D object, because we are having the radiation been coming out in each direction, in every direction. So this is somewhat about the steradian. For circle it is radian, and for steradian it is, for sphere it is steradian. So we have already been found what is the total radian been included in a circle. So we need to find out the total steradian been included in the sphere. So by considering a simple logic, I hope you can understand. Here we have been considering the length, here we are considering the area. So we need an area of R square. So for a sphere, the total area is 4 pi R square, right? The total area included in a sphere, it is 4 pi R square. So total steradian or total solid angle, it is 4 pi R square by R square, is 4 pi steradian. So steradian, it is the measure of solid angle. So this angle is known as solid angle. So solid angles, solid angle having the unit of steradian, it is represented by SR, steradian. So solid angle, I'm just writing here, solid angle subtended by a sphere, it will be 4 pi R square by R square, that is 4 pi steradian. So if we compare radian and steradian, radian requires a length of R, but steradian requires total area of R square. So we can say one steradian is equals to one radian square. One steradian is equals to one radian square, because radian requires R, steradian requires R square. So we can say one steradian is equals to one radian square. So one radian is 180 by pi degree. So 180 by pi degree. So it's supposed to have the square. So if we do the square and taking the solved value for this 180 square by pi square, it is coming out as 3282.8064. Degree square means square degrees. Square degree. So therefore, total steradian for a sphere in terms of square degree, it will be 4 pi steradian is equals to 3282.8064 into 4 pi. It is 41253 square degrees, or is equals to solid angle in a sphere. It is the total solid angle in a sphere. So this is the total solid angle for a sphere. How? Because this steradian is square of radian. So radian is, one radian is 180 by pi degree. So from that, if we do the square, we can find out what is the total square degrees been included for a sphere. Now when we have been considering beam area, means how much area been included in a major lobe or minor lobe or total radiation of the antenna. So if we are having a differential area within that beam area by taking a specified angular limit either in the theta value or in the phi value. We can, by doing the integration, we can find out the total beam area. But within integration, within the limit, will give us the total area. So let us have a 3D representation for a differential area for a spherical coordinate system. It is z, x, y. So let us take a differential area. Let us consider this is the differential area. So we have a specific value of r. We can have a specific value of theta. So this is your theta, this one will be your d theta, differential elevation angle d theta. We can have this projection here on the xy plane. This is your phi, this one will be your d phi, right? This is the same as the radius we are considering. So we need to find out this differential area. This differential area means this side of this area. So if we have been writing this length, this is arc length of r d phi, because this length should be radius into angle. S is equals to r theta. So here r theta, so this length will be your r d phi, right? This is the same radius r, this is your d theta. So this side will be your r d theta, this side will be your r d theta, right? So if this is theta, this side will be your, this side will be your r sin theta. Just try to understand, this is your theta, this is the 90 degree. So sorry, this is the 90 degree, this angle is the 90 degree. So obviously this side is r sin theta, sin component. So what will be this arc length? This is this radius into this angle. So what is this angle? This angle is d phi. So this one will be r sin theta d phi. So what will be this differential area dA? dA will be your this side and this side. So we can consider r d theta into r sin theta d phi. So this dA is r square sin theta d phi. So this is the differential area. So for this differential area, how much differential solid angle been included? That is been given by d omega. That is dA by r square. This is your differential area on a sphere, on the surface of the sphere. So due to this differential area, how much solid angle been included? If we take the comparison with respect to steradian, so one steradian is r square. So this is sin theta d phi steradian. So if someone asks what is the total solid angle been included for a sphere, so we can directly say that dA, if we consider dA is equals to r square d omega. So if we take the integration for whole theta value and phi value, we can able to find out what is the total surface area. So what is the total surface area? That's supposed to be theta between 0 to pi, phi between 0 to 2s pi, r square d omega is your sine theta d phi. So if you do this integration, you can able to find out that it is same as 4 pi r square. Any doubt up to this? Anyone? It is very important because all of the realization for the radiation pattern will be based on this concept. Anyone having any doubt on this? So if yes. Which one? This one. This length, you need to find out this length first, this side. Since this is your theta, this is your 90 degrees, so it's supposed to be sine component. So this is your d phi, this angle is d phi, so this is your radius. This is the same projection here on the xy plane, because we have been going with this azimuthal plane. So on the azimuthal plane, this slit of this on the surface of the sphere, it will be having this angle, differential angle d phi. So this is your r d phi. So this angle is considered as same as this radius into this angle.
Sir, that is down where you have shown the angle phi.
This one?
Yes.
This length is r phi theta. So this length is on the azimuthal plane. So now if we take another value of theta, so just try to understand, if we consider theta value is equals to 90 degree on xy plane, obviously theta will be 90, right? So if we put theta is equals to 90, so it will come r d phi, same as that one on the azimuthal plane. But at some other region other than on the xy plane, for other value of theta, so obviously this sine component we need to consider. That why it is r sine theta d phi. So obviously if we consider on the theta is equals to 0, it is 0 on this line z axis. Clear?
Yes sir.
Anyone having any other doubt? You people should need to think. If you didn't have any doubt, means you are not at all been thinking at all. Just try to think as one football. On the football, if some you are having some football shape, something like that, some honeycomb shape of things have been stitches on the football surface. So if you have been having this circular shape of areas on the football surface, so how this area should be? So that will be taken by this concept. So for any radiation pattern, if someone asks what is the total solid angle been included, so we need to take out this dA, and depending upon this theta and phi limit, we need to take the integration. So obviously for an isotropic radiator, this theta and phi will be the maximum value, so that will be same as the total surface area. That is known as beam area. So along the direction of that beam, what is the total area been included? Clear? So this dA is known as beam area. Okay? And d omega, it is the total solid angle been included. Next, we'll go with radiation intensity. So, obviously we have been seen that through this solid angle only we can have the radiation pattern. So whenever we are having the radiation pattern, we can say yes, that much solid angle been included for that radiation. So this intensity is the power level within that solid angle, that is known as power radiated from the antenna per unit solid angle. Power radiated from the antenna per unit solid angle. So this radiation intensity, it is in far field parameter. It is a far field parameter, and it can be obtained by multiplying the radiation pattern. So radiation density, what is the radiation density we will find by the square of the distance so radiation density with the square. So why square? Because this r square will give us the concept of solid angle, that is steradian. So if you are having a radiation which has been observed at a far distance point, so if you take that length as the radius, and if you have been drawing an sphere by taking that radius, so that sphere with that radius, how much steradian it can have within the direction of that radiation, that will give you the concept of radiation intensity. So if you take the square of that distance, obviously you are considering the solid angle. So by taking that solid angle and multiplying with the radiation density, so we'll have the radiation intensity. So within that solid angle means, if you are having from this center, if you are having a surface area with this r square, so in that location or in that direction, how much radiation or power is been throwing from that antenna, or at distance object, how much it is been observing the power level, so from that antenna. So that is known as radiation intensity. So that is represented by U, capital U. U is equals to R square into W rad. So U is the radiation intensity that is unit is watt per unit solid angle. W rad, it is radiation density that is watt per meter square. So let us see what is this radiation density or radiation power density. Now we already know the power associated with an EM wave. Associated with an EM wave, electromagnetic wave, is the instantaneous pointing vector. Let us write, earlier we have written with respect to P, let us write with respect to W, because we have been represented with W rad. Instantaneous is equals to E instantaneous cross H instantaneous. So the unit for this, it is watt per meter square. For this it is volt per meter, and for this it is ampere per meter. Now since this pointing vector is the power density per meter square, so the total power crossing an closed surface, it can be obtained by taking the integration within that surface area. The total power crossing a closed surface can be obtained by integrating the normal vector. Normal component of pointing vector. Over the entire surface area. Therefore, P, it is closed surface area instantaneous dot ds. We can write this one as instantaneous dot ds is normal vector into dA. Now for the time varying field, we need to take the average. For time varying field, the average power density is, we need to take the integration with respect to T. Vector is obtained by integrating the instantaneous pointing vector over one period and dividing by the period. So this time-varying instantaneous E and H field is x comma y comma z, as well as it is varying on time. So this one can be written as e of x comma y comma z e to the power g omega t for this magnetic field real of g omega t. So this real of e to the power j omega t can be written as half of to the power j omega t plus conjugate to the power minus j omega t. We can write like this. So by real, we'll go with this values. Same for this magnetic field, we can write half of h j omega t plus h conjugate e to the power minus j omega t. So if we go with this instantaneous pointing vector, so this w instantaneous, that is e instantaneous cross h instantaneous, that is half of e to the power e j omega t plus e cross e to the power minus j omega t cross half of j omega t plus conjugate e to the power minus j omega t. So from here we need to take out different values. So if you take this one first, 1 by 4 e cross h conjugate plus 1 by 4 e conjugate cross h plus 1 by 4 e cross h e to the power j twice omega t plus 1 by 4 e conjugate cross h conjugate e to the power minus j twice omega t. Okay, now we can write 1 by 4 real e cross h conjugate, it is same as 1 by 4 real of e cross h, e conjugate cross h, and 1 by 4 real of e cross h e to the power j twice omega t is equals to 1 by 4 real of e conjugate cross h conjugate e to the power minus j twice omega t. So therefore we can write this instantaneous pointing vector is equals to half real of e cross h conjugate plus half of real of e cross h e to the power j twice omega t. Now this is the instantaneous value. We need to take the average value, that is time average pointing vector. Pointing vector, that is average power density. W average x comma y comma z is instantaneous value x comma y comma z, we are taking that average, that is half of real of e cross h conjugate, that is w average x y comma z, it is coming out as half of real of e cross h conjugate. Watt per meter square, this is the average power density or radiation power density, that is what we are having, that is w red, average power density, or this is average power density, or radiation power density. Now if we are having this average value, so what is the total power? So the total power can be find out simply by taking this surface area. So this total power P, or total pointing vector, total power crossing the closed surface, it is the P radiated, that is total power radiated. So therefore P rate or P average, it is closed surface area W rate dot ds, that is closed surface area W average, it is radiation power density or average power density into n cap dA. It is equals to half of closed surface area real value of E cross H conjugate dot ds. This is the total power radiated. So we can say this total power, it is also the measure of radiation intensity. So if we are having the radiation intensity and we know at which angle we are having the radiation intensity, we can find out the total radiated power. We can also say the total power is obtained by integrating the radiation intensity over entire solid angle, because if we are having the radiation intensity, because we already derived this W rad, so alpha into W rad is the radiation intensity. So this total radiated power, so total radiated power can be found out either by taking this radiation density within this total closed surface area, or radiation intensity throughout the entire solid angle, that is P rad is 4 pi. 4 pi means theta is equals to 0 to pi and phi is equals to 0 to 2s. U, radiation intensity within the total solid angle, d omega, or 0 to 2s pi, 0 to pi, u, d omega is sin theta, d phi. So this is one way to find out this period, this and the way to find out this radiation, total power radiation. Clear? Any doubt? Anyone having any doubt on this?